All right, folks. Welcome to the Neg Dog Sports Network. 1-0 Mets over the Nats in real life. 4-1 Yankees over the Orioles. 3-0 Cards. Braves, Phillies. Tigers, Blue Jays. And, of course, our game of the day, the Rays. Astros versus the Rays. Verlander and Snell, and we'll be simulating that game right now on the Neg Dog Virtual Sports Network.
Are you ready? Is you ready?
Ready?
You say you ready? Whole squad ready?
Ready?
Is you ready? Are you ready?
Ready?
All right, folks. Here we go.
We came here to see.
Are you ready?
MLB Network coming your way from Tropicana Field here in St. Petersburg, Florida. Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the Houston Astros and the Tampa Bay Rays. It's going to be fun marveling at two of the best in the game, and it's next on MLB Network. Blake Snell gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. What's your take on him, Dan?
They're going to have to start calling this guy Blake Nasty. This guy is one of the top pitchers in all of baseball. My opinion, the best stuff from the left side in the game right now. Upper to mid-90s fastball, 95 to 98. Good curveball, good changeup, good slider. He throws any pitch at any time for strikes. He's taken that next step. We're talking about a legitimate Cy Young contender year after year. Blake Snell, as good as anybody in the game right now.
One ball, no strikes to count. And now this misses as well as he's behind the leadoff man this afternoon, 2-0 now.
That was one of the easiest takes he'll have all year, and it puts him in a great hitter's count. He's got to take advantage of this situation.
Too high, and it's 3-0. Lifted down the line and left. Pham sprinting after it, but this will land untouched. And that misses for ball four, so it's a five-pitch walk to get us started here this afternoon. Stepping up to the plate, Jose Altuve. He'll get to take his first cuts here. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
1-0.
Curveball is nowhere close, and it's 1-0.
This is where he might need a mound visit, whether it be from the shortstop, his pitching coach, or the catcher. These last couple of pitches have certainly gotten away from him.
The 1-0 home. Runner goes. Is put in play to the right side of the infield. And indeed, he won't try to force it at second. He'll just flip on to first for the sure out. So a runner aboard at second here with one away. And that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. Has a look, now the pitch. Now a changeup to start him out, but that's looked at down and in for ball one. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. and he misses low with it, 2-0.
That's a pretty tough spot for him to deal with in the first inning. Runner in scoring position already, and now he's got the three-hitter salivating in a good hitter's count.
Springer leads off second with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1.
Some guys are great low ball hitters, but most guys, especially guys with pop like this, they're hunting for the ball belt high and above. So that was a nicely spotted fastball down in the zone.
In the air out to left. Moving under it, Pham. He's got it, and there are two down now. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. And that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. Here's the first pitch to him. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Brantley is known to have an incredible ability to make contact when he swings the bat, becoming a rare thing to see him swing and miss, leading many people to marvel at his apparent hand-eye capabilities. Especially in today's game, with such a high strikeout rate out there, he's becoming more of a rare talent.
Yeah, just don't think he's trying to do too much. He gets himself into good hitters' counts and tries to hit it right back off the pitcher's hat.
Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two.
That's one of the hardest things to do in this game. You know he's sitting fastball. That ball starts to slide away from him. You have to have some serious strong hands and wrists not to commit right there.
Three balls and a strike to Houston's left fielder. And there are the umpires assigned to this one. Calling balls and strikes is Mr. Mike Fillmore.
Hey, you know, D-Roll, Mike Fillmore, he'll give a little bit off the edges, but he gets the respect not only from the pitchers, but from the players because his zone is consistent.
Yeah, as long as he's consistent, Dan, I'm okay with Mike Fillmore's zone. If a pitcher's pounding that zone, he wants to give a little bit off the outer edge, I'm okay with that.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. That one bends into the zone. A strike on the breaking ball.
Hey, he's not going to get away with that all day. He's got to find a way to get on top of that ball and bury it.
The 0-1 offering. And boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there. And it's 0-2 now. Two down, runners at first and second. Here's the 0-2. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. It's on to the bottom of the first. No score on MLB Network. Justin Verlander is on the mound for the season opener on the road in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Yeah, Matt, since he's put on a Houston Astros uniform, Justin Verlander's kind of turned his career around. Went through a couple of seasons where his velocity was down, but he's always had that good curveball changeup combination. D-low back up to the mid to upper 90s to go along with that fastball and the curveball, and Justin Verlander is all the way back.
Digging in, Austin Meadows. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. First pitch on its way from Verlander. And here's a fastball called for strike one. The windup and the 0-1. And this catches the inside corner. Good spot there. It's 0-2.
You know, from an offensive standpoint, they already knew they had their work cut out for him against a great pitcher. But if he's going to locate like that.
High and deep to straightaway right. Springer looking up. Gone! It's a solo home run for Austin Meadows. First home run of the campaign for him as the Rays move out on top 1-0.
Hey, you come out of spring training feeling pretty good about your swing, and how about this, your first at bat of the year? Kaboom! This could lead to a very big year. First at bat, home run, not a bad way to start.
Stepping in now, Tommy Pham. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. Pham with an even 1-1 count now. Verlander is a guy that's able to keep the bat off the ball. That's kind of the name of the game for a pitcher, and as a starter, it really helps him work deep into games.
Matty V, one of the toughest parts about scoring runs is bunching three or four hits together an inning, and that's one of the things this guy does really well. He's tough to hit, and he's really tough to get three or four hits off of. That's one of the reasons why he's one of the better pitchers.
That's a good take on that fastball there. You know he's looking for something up there to drive, but that was just a little above his happy zone. Not everyone has the discipline to hold back on those.
All even now, 2-2. Base is empty here with nobody out.
Back-to-back breaking balls. He just missed that one right there, fouling it away. Do not expect a third.
Here now the 2-2. Line to the right side, but that's a foul ball. Another try at 2-2. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Fastball too high, ball four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Up next for the Rays, G-Man Choi, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First pitch of the at-bat. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Pham aboard here at first with nobody out.
Nope.
Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. A ball and two strikes now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Into the box now, Brandon Lowe, as he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. Ready with the 0-1. Ripped down the line, and he tries for the backhand reach at third, but it gets by the glove down the line.
Hey, guys, that was a nice job by the batter right there. He's able to get his front foot down early, recognize the backdoor slider, stay inside it, and drive it the other way.
A And that'll bring in Yandy Diaz as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one.
Hey, he finds himself in a tough situation early, and he's going to have to execute a pitch to get out of it. But if he does, it'll build confidence, and he starts rolling as the later innings start happening.
Now a fastball for a called strike. It's one and one.
You can clearly see that the hitter didn't like that strike call, and his manager, he didn't like it either, as he's given the umpire an earful from that dugout.
First and second now, one man out. Right down the chute that time, one and two.
All right, let's take a step back right here. He's down 1-2, three fastballs in a row. There is no way he's throwing him a fourth.
Now a ground ball for Altuve, could be two. Spin throw gets him at first. A great play there as runners do move up to second and third.
Not sure the spin throw was necessary there, but it sure looked good. Would have been questionable if he threw it away, but he put it right on the money for the out.
And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. Popped him up. Bregman has a play. And they'll avoid the big inning as he makes the catch, so just the one run scores here in the frame. Rays off and running early on the solo home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now 1-0 Tampa. Stepping in, Tyler White. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Here comes the first pitch. Now the fastball is swung on and missed. And here's a pitch high and tight for a ball, one and one. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. In the air, out to right. That's a hit, their first of the new season. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
When it left his bat, I thought it might squirt foul, but it hugged the line and found its way into the corner. Thought it might be a little bit closer play at second, but he cruised in there with relative ease.
Standing in now, Robinson Chirinos, as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. White leads off second with nobody out. One and one to Chirinos.
What good inside fastball right there. Trying to tie the hitter up, trying to keep him from getting those arms extended. A pitcher's pitch.
Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. Now the 2-1 pitch. The count now at 2-2. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out.
That was aggressive pitching in that at bat, and I like seeing that. He showed all hard stuff until the fifth and final pitch for the strikeout. When you work off your hard stuff, it really opens up your secondary pitches to be more deceptive.
And that'll bring up Aledmys Diaz. He grounds it sharply to third. In time to first, and there are two away.
Well, I think he got away with one right there. It was a fastball right down the middle, and he hit it hard, but he couldn't elevate it at all. Would have been a different story if he did.
So striding in, Jake Mariznick, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. From the stretch, and a ball 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
The 1-1. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
The 2-1 pitch. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
34 pitches for him through an inning and two-thirds right now. That's not terrible, but it's a lot higher than he'd like.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
Digging in, George Springer. He drew a walk his first time up. First pitch of the at-bat, and a fastball is in there for strike one.
Great job of getting back in the zone with a hard fastball after the walk. I think he might have let a little frustration out with that pitch.
Two men are on with two men out. A ball and a strike to Houston's leadoff batter. Fouled off. Fouled away. Here's the 1-2. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Two left for the Astros. They're down 1-0. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Willy Adames. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Here's the first pitch to him. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. And he looks at a slider in there, 1-1. Now a fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1. Three and one.
He walked the guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
At the plate, Kevin Kiermaier. delivery to him on the way. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. That one's down around the knees, taken for a strike. A runner at first with no outs here. And this one gets away. And a bad time for that as the runner takes second here.
That was definitely a two-strike curveball there. The catcher turns his glove over and tries to make himself big to block it, but with no luck. The ball skips away, and it scored a wild pitch.
The 1-2 misses for the second ball.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think it can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Oh, and ouch, that one drilled him. Thankfully, he's able to recover, and he gets the second out at first. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. So it's back to the top of the order now, and Austin Meadows will be the next at bat.
Yeah, that last at bat, Danny, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Hit softly down the line at first, but this is foul for the first strike. Adames on third with two out. Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Rays strand just the one. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First pitch on its way. And he fouls this one off. Wind up and the 0-1. Pops this one up. Wendell moving to his left. One away. Now at the plate, Alex Bregman. Flied out in his first at bat, so making 0-for-1 so far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Pham is underneath this one. And that's out number two. So here's the cleanup hitter. Michael Brantley reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. Now here's the pitch. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no strikes. The 1-0. It is taken. Strike one.
You know, hats off to the pitcher right there. You got a great hitter at the plate. It's early in the count, and he wanted to get ahead. Nice challenge pitch right there.
from. The windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. The 1-2. Grounded back up the middle. Adames picks it up. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Astros go down 1-2-3. It remains 1-0. Now batting, Tommy Pham, as we move on to the bottom of inning number 3. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball swung on and missed.
I know he got a swinging miss right there, but that was a hittable location to a really good hitter. I don't know if he gets those back if he continues to miss in those spots.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Two and two.
The MO of this pitcher in the early going is certainly establishing the inside part of the plate. He has been dominant. Sometimes you just got to tip your hat if a guy can effectively, consistently pitch inside like he is.
Still 2-2. Another 2-2. Popped straight up. White on the move. He can't get there as it falls in.
Boy, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, D-Row. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit.
Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
G-Man Choi the next to hit. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. The 1-0 is in there for strike one.
Plain to see right there that the manager's sticking up for his hitter, making sure that that strike zone gets a little bit tighter. It's tough to cover both sides of the plate, and they both want that strike zone to be shrinked up a little bit.
1-1, here it is. 2-1. Pham gets his lead at first, nobody out. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full down, 3-2.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
He's set. Here's the 3-2, and it's fouled away. Now a chopper to second. This will be a tough turn. Scooped up. Throw on to first in time. One away. Striding forward now is the DH, Brandon Lowe. 1-for-1 after a single his first time up.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
One ball, no strikes to count.
Oh.
2-0.
Clearly staying away from him in this at-bat with that runner in scoring position tells me they're trying to force him to reach for something and maybe roll over on it.
Runner at second here with one man out. Hit on the ground out to short. On to first, and there are two down. Coming to the plate now, Yandy Diaz. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Verlander pauses. Here comes the first pitch. On the right at first, and that ends the inning. One left for Tampa, but they're on top 1-0. Now the Astros' designated hitter, Yuli Gurriel, comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. A 2-0 count to the Astros' DH.
You know, sometimes it takes a pitcher a few pitches to get going, but those two pitches weren't even close. Ball's behind it, count 2-0. It's time to start getting locked in.
Now the 2-0. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly would have got them on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. The 2-1. Drilled right back up the middle. Adames brings it in. And he's going to beat the offline throw to first as the first baseman couldn't get the foot back in time. Trying to pick things up where he left off, Tyler White. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a ribby.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Starts him out with a curveball for a strike. Fouled off. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Not a bad pitch right there on 0-2, a fastball. And I think as a hitter right now, you have to continue to go up there looking to hit off the fastball.
The 1-2 pitch. Now a curveball misses inside. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. And another foul ball.
I would say the pitcher would tell us up here that that wasn't great execution, but he definitely had him off balance. That is a pitch in his arsenal that he can go to.
The 2-2 one more time. Fouled away. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
Another full count offering on its way. Ani pops it up, drifting just beyond the infield. Wendell will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone. Digging in, Robinson Chirinos. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
First pitch of the at bat. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
The 1-0 is taken for ball two.
Two balls, no strike.
Gurriel stands at first with one out. And here's a ball hit in the air. Meadows is over, and he puts it away in foul ground for the second out. So a runner at first with two away, and that'll bring up the shortstop, Oledmus Diaz. First pitch on its way. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. No runs, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And a pitch up and in, keeping him honest, 1-1. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Wendell is there, and the side is retired. One left for Houston. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. We're back at Tropicana Field, and let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. So striding forward now, Joey Wendell. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
Here's the 0-1. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. He takes the turn and heads for second. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Wow, not sure what the pitcher was thinking, serving up a fastball right over the heart of the plate. His eyes got as big as saucers as he blasts this thing, putting himself into scoring position to start off the inning.
In now, Willy Adames, as he'll take a first pitch curveball right down the middle for strike one. A 1 pitch on its way. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
He's attacking this hitter a lot more aggressively than he did the first time when he faced him and issued a walk, coming right after him here.
0-2, here it is. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. One run, four hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Hit to first. White brings it in, and it's a productive first out as that runner's able to advance 90 feet up to third here. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
And they start him out with a slider. Good spot, but he doesn't get the call. 1-0. Ball two.
Remember, he was a strikeout victim last time up, but this at bat seems to be a totally different direction. He's showing good patience now, and he's got a real good count at 2-0.
2-0 count, the pitch outside. 3-0 now.
With the infield back and a runner at third, he's definitely pitching for a strikeout or maybe something like a harmless pop-up. You could see it from that high fastball, but that was just a good job of laying off that pitch.
And, oh, they won't let him walk that easily, as that somehow ruled a strike. 3-1 now. A full count to the Rays center fielder. The 3-2 pitch, and he misses with one here. It's ball four, so that'll at least bring the double play into the conversation with runners at the corners and one away.
Well, when you go with a slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Here now is Mike Zunino, and he's got runners at the corners here with only one gone. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Counts 1-0.
And that misses ball one. A ball and a strike to Mike Zunino. Runners are at the corners with one man out. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher.
With two strikes and the runners at the corners, this is a big pitch coming up. Got to execute to hope to either get a strikeout or a double play ball to help you get out of this thing.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2.
Well, I think this is the kind of approach they need against such a prolific starter. You can't count on putting up a lot of runs, so getting him out of the game has to be the priority. Working at bats, full counts, running up the pitch count is a great way of doing that.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Mike Zunino becomes out number two this inning.
I really like that he gave up nibbling out of the zone trying to get in the chase. That wasn't working, so he just reached back and fired a good old country hardball fastball right by him. No better feeling in the world when you're a pitcher than throwing a fastball right by a guy.
A hit and two tries for him so far. Fastball just off the inside corner. Hit weakly back to the mound. On to first, and the Rays are kept off the scoreboard here as the side is retired. Rays strand a pair, but they lead it 1-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Astros manager A.J. Hinch between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've already worked out 3 walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Thank you, Heidi. Here's Jake Marisnik. He drew a base on balls his first time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Line drive to left. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So the Astros put a man aboard to get the inning underway.
Hey, so far it's been easy pickings for this pitcher. He's gone through this lineup almost unscathed.
But right there, leadoff single, middle part of the game. Let's see if he makes an adjustment before they do.
Here's George Springer. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that ball will stay fair and it's gone, a home run.
George Springer puts two on the board with that home run. First home run of the campaign for him, and the Astros take the lead. It's 2-1.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
Stepping in now, Jose Altuve, as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. No hits to this point. Now the 1-0 is laid off for ball two. Hits are now even at four apiece. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve. The 2-1 home. Even count, two balls and two strikes. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
With the meat of the order due up next, you could probably expect to see something you can handle here with the full count as the two-hole hitter.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. Wendell ranges to his left. On to first, so a good bounce-back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. That'll bring up the former first-rounder Alex Bregman. 0-for-2 for him to this point. First pitch of the at-bat. Nowhere close with the fastball to begin the at-bat. It's ball one. Still only one out in the inning. Counts even 1-1 to Alex Bregman.
Pretty adamant about working him inside right now. Back-to-back fastballs, and that one was able to find the zone.
Now the 1-1 pitch is a fastball down below the knees. Mine to the right side. Meadows back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
Boy, sometimes they say you hit it hard and good things will happen. Well, that's not the case right there. That was a bullet that just stayed up and is caught in the outfield.
Here's Michael Brantley. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1.
This guy's cruising along, pitching well as we enter the middle innings of this one. Less than 60% of his first pitches have been for strikes. If he could clean that up a little bit, he could really roll into the later innings in this one.
Nope.
Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. This one's down to third. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And, oh, the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he'll reach it first.
Well, a part of me wants to applaud him for staying with it and making the throw, but after he bobbled it, he should have just eaten the ball and lived to fight another day. As it is, he gets tagged with an error, and a man is on base.
Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Hit hard to short. And he'll go the short way to retire the shot. Astros play two on the two-run home run. Bottom of the fifth coming up. 2-1 Houston. At the plate, Tommy Pham. Last time through was a base hit. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Slider finds the zone for a strike. And he wastes a fastball high there, 1-2.
You know, Matty, I'm not surprised by that pitch. Raise the eye level a little bit. Maybe we get something bouncing in the dirt right here.
The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. Takes this the other way to right. Springer is there, one away.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Into the box, G-Man Choi. As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And he fouls this one off. The 1-1 is strike two swinging.
Yeah, Matty, he's had these guys on the proverbial rocking horse all night. Changing speeds, hitting every quadrant. He's tough to hit.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
I think if he executes that pitch on the corner instead of off of it, he probably gets some pretty weak contact, if anything. He jammed him pretty hard on the previous pitch, so my bet was he was going to try to cheat on the inside part, thinking it might be coming again.
And it's fouled away.
Little guessing game going on right now. Being late on that fastball after the change, he had to be sitting off speed right there.
Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late, had no chance to put that ball in play.
Standing in now, Brandon Lowe. As he'll take a look at ball one. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Verlander's ready with the 1-1 pitch. Ground ball foul down the left side. Here it comes. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score.
Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Rays DH. Yandy Diaz would be next. And this is taken low for ball 4, and they'll have themselves a 2-out base runner here after all.
Well, you never want to issue a free pass if you can help it, but when a hitter like that digs in, you'd rather he's standing at first than driving a ball out of here and erasing your one-run lead.
Standing in, Yandy Diaz. He's rolled into ground outs a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Deliver. Here's the first pitch. Strike taken up in the zone.
This is where you got to take stock in the situation. Adjust your batting gloves and realize you need a gapper to score this guy from first. If nothing less, pass the baton to the guy behind you and keep the line moving.
A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Two mid-90s fastballs and you're down 0-2. This is where you got to take a deep breath and pop commit. You're either all in on another fastball or you're finding a way to stay back to attack something off speed.
Ball. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Rays strand just the one. Our score remains 2-1. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Tyler White. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he lays off there, 1-0. A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. Now the 1-0. Seared down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. There's a swing, and he sends the ball high in the air into left field. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to left. First home run of the campaign for him. And with it, the Astros have taken a 3-1 lead.
Boy, that's a late mistake that could prove to be fatal. It's only a solo shot, but with the way their starter is throwing it, that could be enough to seal the deal.
Now here comes the Tampa Bay manager out to the mound, and we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. He'll wind up lasting just 5 innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Ryan Yarbrough takes over on the mound here with nobody out in the 6th inning. In now, Robinson Chirinos. A ball and no strikes. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. There's a changeup taken, but it finds the zone on the inside. Hard hard hit toward the hole. Adames scoops it up. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning. Into the box now, Aledmys Diaz. One run in and one gone so far this inning. First offering on its way. And a called strike down in the zone, nothing and one. Yarbrough, a 6'5" left-hander. This is his first year at the big league level. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Might have been looking to find that outside corner, but he couldn't quite get it there. It's 1-2. One out, nobody on. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. A bouncer up the middle to his right, Wendell. Throw gets him, two down. Digging in and looking for more, Jake Mariznick. He singled his last time up. First pitch on its way. Here's a swing and a ground ball. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Oh. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. The 1-2 misses. Nope, ball two.
Two balls, two strikes.
So a full count now.
When a pitcher's close to working through a quick inning, that's when you really need to grind out some at-bats. He's done a good job of that, and that's really big when you're hitting towards the bottom of the order.
Frozen on strike three for the final out of the inning. Astros get a run here courtesy of a solo homer. On to the bottom of the sixth. It's now 3-1 Houston. Leading off the inning, Joey Wendell, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Pitch on the way. Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1.
Oh, he thanks his lucky stars right there getting away with that hanger. I cannot believe he didn't pull the trigger on that pitch.
Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. On his way to pitch number 100. Right side. White picks it up. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Wow. Striding in, Willie Adames. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Ball one.
He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss.
Ball one strike.
Ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop.
Yeah, right there, it's tough to be able to dive out over the plate. I know it's a pitch people think you can get to, but after you're pounded in twice, that ball looks like a foot outside.
Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Brinkley is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. Ready now, Kevin Kiermaier. It was a walk in his last trip. First pitch on its way from Verlander. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes.
This offense is going to have to find a way to get going. It's happened in the past. Every team goes through it where everyone seems to fall into a funk at the same time. Everyone needs to relax and not try and be the hero and just start getting the leadoff guy on.
This pitch is popped up. Bregman is there. And that retires the side. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. Score holds. It's 3-1. Back here at Tropicana Field in St. Pete. It's on to the seventh now with the Astros on top in this one. And as the final warm-up tosses are thrown, let's get a look at our game summary through six innings. So the Houston lineup turns over, and to the plate, George Springer. He'll lead it off here as we begin inning number seven.
It'll be interesting to see if they use that changeup in this at-bat. That last at-bat, that was a changeup he hit for a home run. I'm going to see if this time they don't go to more fastballs and curveballs.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Now the 1-0 is laid off, but in there for strike one.
We're seeing quite a few pitches up from him right now, and that can obviously be dangerous. A called strike there, but he might need to lower his sights a little bit.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, and he whiffs on it as this ball's right under his glove.
And that's one of those plays that stay with you for an entire game. You want to get the first out on what appears to be a routine play, but you can't get it done. The good news, he has some time to redeem himself.
Next up for the Stros, Jose Altuve, leadoff man on base, and we'll see what they have in mind strategy-wise here. He's set. Here it comes. And this is on the outside corner for strike one.
To me, getting ahead 0-1, it's the most important pitch in the game, Matty. It puts the hitter on the defensive. I can only think of myself being in the batter's box. When I'm sitting 1-0, I am all over the gas, or I am allowed the opportunity to sit on something without fearing going 1-1. When you're down 0-1, your head's on a swivel.
Yeah. One and two now as that one's fouled off. The 1-2. Oh, on the ground to short. Could this be two? One there. On to first. Not in time as he just hits the bag ahead of the throw. So a runner at first now with one away. And that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. First offering on its way. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. The 1-0. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. To second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Nothing doing there for Houston as the lead remains 3-1. Chris Devinsky gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Riding in once again, Mike Zunino. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
First delivery to him on the way. Now a swing and a fly ball. White in foul ground, but this will land untouched. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. The 1-1. Fouled off. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
Pretty good discipline right there with two strikes. That's a tough sweeping slider. Not many guys lay off that pitch.
The 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. A payoff pitch one more time. Now a ball lined to the left side, but foul. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Leading off the inning, your job is to get on base and set the table for the inning. That was a pretty good at bat, and then he pushed the count to 3-2 and made the pitcher work. But I think he'd like to have that 3-2 pitch back. Pretty sure that was ball four he went after.
Stepping in now, Austin Meadows. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And that's in there for his strike, 1-1.
Somebody needs to go rattle a cage right here, take the bats and start throwing them all over the dugout to get these boys going. If this continues, I guarantee you, you see a different lineup tomorrow.
Two and one to the Rays leadoff batter. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. Nip the corner. 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Now at the plate, Tommy Pham. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch-out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. First pitch of the at-bat.
Nope.
Lays off 1-0.
Well, he punched out the last guy, but he didn't get any favors from the blue on the first pitch in this at-bat. Probably should be ahead of this hitter instead of behind.
Two out, nobody on. On a great pitch there, caught him reaching. It's 1-1.
I'll tell you, if I'm pitching right now, I'm not throwing anything near the strike zone until these guys prove they can lay off it. They're just being way too aggressive.
The 1-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good inning's work out of the bullpen here.
Swing, and there it goes. He got all of that ball, and that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. A solo shot that time for Tommy Pham. First home run of the campaign for him, and the Rays get a bit closer. It's now a 3-2 ball game.
Yeah, and you could see he just made a mistake. He was cruising in the seventh, getting the first two outs, but then he offered up one that caught a little bit too much of the plate. This one got up and out of here, ruining what looked like a good appearance out of the bullpen.
Brad Pica takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning. Into the box now, G-Man Choi, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. And a strike to even the count, 1-1. Right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
One ball.
Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Rays get one back here thanks to the solo home run. We'll march on to the eighth. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Striding in for Houston, Michael Brantley. He was able to reach base thanks to an error in his last at-bat. First pitch coming. Here it is. Sinker on the inside, and that's a strike. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage of it.
You know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Two balls, one strike.
And this is low, ball two. 2-1. The 2-1 home. Hit hard on the ground to the right. And this is going to find its way into right for a base hit. The leadoff man's on to start the eighth. Late now is the designated hitter, Yuli Gurriel. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. Is right there as Zunino made that caught-stealing look easy.
Well, they've got a small lead, and they're pushing to add to it by being aggressive on the base pass. But as a manager, you just hope you're not giving up outs that you wish you could have had back.
This one, everything we could have hoped for. 3-2 in inning number eight. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
That has to make you feel really good as a pitcher, right? You're making pitches all around the zone, and then you bring that one inside. You can't do anything with it. What does it do? It just locks you up inside. You have no chance to put the ball in play.
Tyler White will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. Two out, nobody on. A ball and a strike to count to the Astros' first baseman. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. The 1-2 is a ball below the zone. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. Robinson Chirinos would be next. Now the 3-2 pitch. He loses him on ball four. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up the catcher, Robinson Chirinos. First pitch on its way. And that misses for ball one. Grounder down the line at third. And this will get by him at third. Down the line. It's a fair ball.
Boy, that's not a bad pitch right there. That's a pretty good sinker. He just happens to hook that one right into left field for a base hit.
Yeah, he got the bat head out right there, Dan, and was able to get that one to left field.
standing in, Aledmys Diaz. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Grounded down the third baseline. Ready with the 0-1. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Pham giving chase. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Two left for the Astros, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Next will be the designated hitter, Brandon Lowe. He's 1-for-2 in the ball game. Now the pitch. Knuckle curve down below the knees, 1-0. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 1-0 finds the zone, strike one. High and wide, two balls and a strike. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
Now at the plate, Yandy Diaz. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one. One and one the count now.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
The 1-1 is a sharp slider that bounces in the dirt. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Bases are empty, one man out. This is on the ground over to first. A dive, and he knocks it down. And there is some stick-to-itiveness as they still manage to get the out at first. What a play. Hector Rondon enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Plate, Joey Wendell. He was a ground-out victim last time up. First delivery to him on the way. And he takes ball one. That's wide, 2-0. The 2-0. He is a heater in there for a strike. And that pitch comes over to catch the corner. It's 2-2 now. Here now the 2-2. This is pulled into right. But a little unlucky there as it's hit right to him in right field for the final out of the inning. Down in order go the Rays. They're down 3-2. Now in the box, Jake Marisnik. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
0-1 the count. Got him out on his front foot. It's 0-2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
Pretty textbook pitching right there. Jump ahead in the count 0-2 and then start working outside the zone. Easier said than done, but that's the way to do it.
George Springer will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. Here's the first pitch to him. Takes this the other way to right. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
You never want to beat a pitcher that breaks a guy out of a slump. But this guy was too good. You knew it was a matter of time before he started barreling baseballs. That gives him a multi-hit game, and I'm sure he's feeling good about it.
So a runner at first now with one away. And striding in the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. He's set, and the pitch. Taking off is Springer. Line drive to left. A dive, but it's off his glove.
Wow, that's surprising right there. Hit and run tactic used to perfection. Balls hit to the outfield. The batter does his job. I don't know how that runner's standing on second still. You tip your hat to the outfield to get it in super quick, but he's got to take the chance to get the third.
Into the box now, Alex Bregman. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0-4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Here comes the first pitch. A ball and no strikes.
You could tell he's starting to get frustrated out there. He's not usually used to getting knocked around the yard a little bit, and you can tell he's starting to feel for it.
One 0 count, here it is. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. You can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
Now the 2-0 home. Shot toward second. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. This will kick up against the wall now. He pulls into third safely as a run will score on the play as well.
Dan, that's a huge insurance run right there. Has to feel good as a hitter right there to not only get a ribby knock, but to give your team a little bit of breathing.
It does, and it makes your pitcher go out there with a little bit more free and easy frame of mind instead of going into a 1-1 game where every pitch is so important. You're one pitch away from a solo tying the game up. That's not the case now.
And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first. So the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk. And the force play is now in order. So bases are loaded. Nowhere to put him with one away. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Here comes the first pitch. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is really important when you're dealing with the bases loaded behind you. Good job to give himself the advantage there.
Here's the 0-1. Liner toward right center. And he has delivered one of the biggest at-bats of the afternoon as he cashes in with a base hit. And the runner from second is in to score. It's now 6-2. Ryan Stanek enters the game with one gone in the top of inning number 9. First assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. From the stretch. Offered it a low one there but came up empty.
Beautifully thrown splitter right there. High 80s, down in the zone. Looks like a fastball coming in and then it just drops off the table. You can get a lot of swinging strikes with that.
Now the 0-1. And this is on the ground is short. Could be two. There's one on to first. And talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. So 3 runs on 4 hits. No errors and a man left on. Bottom part of the order, 7, 8, and 9 due up in the bottom of inning number 9. Houston leads this one 6-2. So coming to the plate, Willy Adames. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First offering on its way. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
Not a bad idea right there. Make this guy work and see if he can throw the ball over the plate. Throws the first pitch for a strike. They need to get some runners on base, and not a bad plan. Unfortunately, the pitcher came in with a strike on the first pitch.
Behind 0-2 now. And here's a slider. Strike three called, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
That's what you call clipping the outside corner. Great movement on that slider, and it completely locked up the hitter. Didn't fool the umpire, though.
Standing in now, Kevin Kiermaier. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Barring any late turnaround, this win would belong to Justin Verlander. One out, nobody on. A ball and a strike. Hit hard down the right field line, but that's a foul ball. The 1-2 is a fastball that misses.
That's the kind of pitch that reminds me of many reasons why I wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and coming in hot, and he just gave a stone-cold take. I'm bailing out of the way if I'm in the box, no doubt about it.
Fouled away. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here. Mike Zunino will be next. Comes with a fastball, but it's outside for ball four.
Well, he battled to get it to a 3-2 count, but that pitch wasn't even close. Now he's got a man on with one out, so he's got to focus on trying to get the ground ball.
settling in now. Mike Zunino, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Pitch coming, here it is. And a high strike there, 0-1. He just ramps up and gears the fastball by him, 0-2.
The guy on the mound must have a different scouting report than we have right here. This looks like a beautiful situation for a double play right here, but he continues to pound up in the zone.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch, and he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
This is what a power pitcher will do to you if he executes his pitches. That was a three-pitch strikeout, and with the kind of stuff that he has, it's not uncommon for him to absolutely dominate certain guys.
Into the box, Austin Meadows, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Now the 1-0. That missed close. It's ball two.
You thank your lucky stars when you get a chance to hit behind a guy with as much speed as he has on first base. The entire defense is on guard, and you know probably there's a fastball coming.
The 2-0 on the way. Left side, but well foul. Set to deliver on 2-1.
Three balls.
Well above the letters with the fastball that time. The 3-1. And there's a called strike two as now they're down to their final strike this afternoon.
Full count with two outs now, so if he could put the ball in the gap somewhere, he could have a good shot of driving in a run because the runner at first will be in motion.
Count remains full. Tampa down to their final strike in this one. Here's the two-seam fastball that bears in a bit too tight. It's ball four.
That is just a great at-bat there. When you're down late, you need base runners any way you can get them, and that never-say-die mentality could be the difference. We'll see how it plays out.
Roberto Ozuna takes over on the mound now as he'll try to get the final out of the ballgame here and pick up a save. Striding into the box, Tommy Pham. And these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb, but hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden, this thing feels doable.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
Now the 1-0 is high and outside for a ball.
2-0.
Kiermaier over at second. Meadows at first, two out in the inning. 2-1 now.
All right, that's when you got to tell yourself to slow down a little bit right there. Out in front on a fastball, hit it hard, but pulled it foul.
And the pitch on 2-1. And he lays off again, ball three.
Well, this is a big pitch right here. Two outs in the ninth. The last thing you want to do is walk a guy and bring the tying run to the plate.
The 3-1 pitch. And that's taken for strike two, as now they're down to their final strike here this afternoon. And a swing and a miss, as they definitely had him reaching for that one, and this ball game is over.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
6-2, the final total today. Houston used a three-run ninth to help propel them to the win. Justin Verlander gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt.